President Muhammadu Buhari will on Thursday attend the meeting of the National Executive Council, NEC, of the All Progressive Congress, APC, summoned by the court-recognized acting chairman of the party, Victor Gaidam. The president's senior special assistant on media and publicity, Gaurav Ashew, confirmed this via his verified Twitter handle on Wednesday. According to the presidential aides, the president has received very convincing advice on the position of the law as far as the situation in the party is concerned and has determined that the law is on the side of Victor Gaidam as acting national chairman. He added that in addition to the president, the Gaidam meeting will hopefully be attended by APC governors and the leaders of the National Assembly. To speak more on this, we're joined by legal practitioner Kolade Olutekunbi. Thank you very much for joining us.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
What's your take on this latest twist to the APC leadership crisis?
Well, what I need to say is that some of us who are not a member of the political party are beginning to think that those who have been put in the hands of affairs to govern us seems not to understand that people are watching them. And that every step that they are taking, people are watching those steps. I cannot conceive within my own conception how the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria will come out to say he will be attending a NEC meeting that is called by a supposed candidate who is not the acting chairman of the political of the party, because we are aware that he has been appointed, the former governor of Oyo State, as the acting national chairman of APC, and that in compliance with the provisions of their constitution, somebody was delegated for him. So who called this next meeting? What is the constitutionality of the next meeting? It will appear to us that APC are not a serious political party.
All right, as a legal mind, I'd like you to help us make sense of this. What is the relationship between the suspension, allegedly, of his membership of the party, his cancellation, rather, his membership was cancelled, and this ruling by the court, and now the president's position? What is the legal understanding you can give to this development?
My understanding is that all the legal hullabaloos that is abroad within the APC, the president should allow the system to operate itself naturally. How can someone who had been suspended, who is no longer, who is having issues with the National Executive Committee of the party, and is who appointed him as the acting chairman? Who gave him the appointment? He appointed himself, and then he's calling NEC meeting, and then the acting chairman, the one that is delegating for the one that was appointed, has issued a statement that party should disregard the NEC meeting, and the president is overruling it. For us, it's just that it's beginning to sound very, very caricatural that APC is not a serious party. They need to be disciplined. Any political party that is not disciplined is going to meet its Waterloo. So they are just sitting. They are sitting on a bomb yet to be exploded.
So what are you expecting? You said yes. Let's just try and be a bit more specific because we're trying to unbundle some of these stories. What do you anticipate? Because according to the statement, the governors on the platform of the APC will be attending. Is APC on the verge of self-destruct ahead of the poll? Or do you see this meeting tomorrow as the rallying point that will, find a point of compromise for all parties involved?
Yeah, if next meeting is to be called, it must be called within the contemplation of their constitution. I mean, if they want to call, nobody is asking them not to call NEC meeting, but they should ensure that they comply with their own constitution, with their own laws. They cannot begin to blow out hot and cold. If it is convenient for them to call NEC meeting, they should call it within the concept, concept of their law, not within the concept of division. Because what we have now is like a division. There are two acting chairmen, one not appointed, one appointed. The one that is not appointed is the one calling the next meeting, and which the president says is going to attend. So what's the basis? They should rationalize it to us so that we can understand. We are not party member, But at least within the concept of what we know, it will look as if they are embarking on illegality.
Some would say, with the president stepping in after being silent for a while and his position in the party at the moment might give some legality to Gaidim's position, some legitimacy rather, not legality, some legitimacy to Gaidim's position. Will that, in effect, in your opinion, override or reinforce the cancellation of the primaries as put forward by Gaidim?
Couldn't the president have called this the current acting chairman to call the next meeting? Couldn't the president, as the leaders of the party, call the acting chairman that is recognized by the National Executive Council? Couldn't the president have asked him to call next meeting? Why must the president be attending a meeting called by someone who was not appointed? That's my mistake. And mind you, it will be abnormal for anyone to begin to rationalize that the primary that we had, pursuant to the acting chairman, the present acting chairman, the one that was organized in Edo State, that cannot be flawed. You can't put any illegality on top of that. It has done legitimately. We will see how the scenario play out tomorrow. We are watching. We want to see what will happen.
Certainly. A lot of Nigerians are interested, as you are. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts on the matter.
Thank you very much.